हेलो किड्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर स्टेइंग फिट एंड हेल्दी दीज डेज. माई सेल्फ मिस सुरभि शर्मा फ्रॉम शिवज्योति एजुकेशनल ग्रुप. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद जीके क्लास 3. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर 18, दैट इज कंप्यूटर आइकन्स. नाउ व्हाट डू यू अंडरस्टैंड बाय दिस टॉपिक कंप्यूटर आइकन्स? When you operate the computer in your computer period or when you are there in the computer labs, you must have seen these icons on the computer, okay? You all must have seen these icons. Now, in this chapter, I am going to tell you what these icons mean. So, let's start. You must have seen different icons on your computer screen. Check your awareness about these icons. Now, let's see how many of you know these icons. Identify each one of them and write their names. Use the given help box. Help box has been given to you at the down. Now let's see. So first one is, yes, which is the first icon? That is of MS Word. All the Word files are included in this. Second one is recycle bin. Okay, you all must have seen this icon also. Whenever you delete some file or whenever you delete something, that goes into the recycle bin. Third one is my computer. Okay, all the drives. Okay, or whenever you want to open some file, that is included in my computer. First you have to open my computer, then you will be able to operate those files. Next, fourth one is Internet Explorer. Okay, Internet Explorer, whenever you want to operate with the internet or whenever you want to use the internet for finding something, you have to open Internet Explorer. Okay, fifth one is MS Excel. Sixth one is Windows Explorer. Seventh one is PowerPoint. Okay, PowerPoint, that is PPTs. Okay, eighth one is Notepad. Whenever you want to add something important or whenever you want to write something, you can open this and write it down here. Ninth one is Paint. Now you all must have opened this icon. Okay, you all must have operated this Paint. You all enjoy Paint. Okay, so this is the icon of Paint. Next we move upon to chapter number 20, that is Indian Sub-Decay. Okay, now this we have read in the previous chapters also. What does it mean? This means that something which is very similar. Okay, you have or like when we give some other name to a place or to anything. Let's see. The nicknames of persons, places or things are called sub-decay nicknames. Okay, so we are going to read about some places in this chapter to which different names has been given. Like for example, Jaipur. Jaipur is also called as Pink City. So this is the other name of Jaipur, Pink City. So we are going to read about such names in this chapter. Here is a list of sub-decay of some Indian cities. Find their names using the help box. Help box is here. Okay, write down the spellings very carefully. You can look the spellings from here. Okay, so first one is City of Ghats. City of Ghats, that is Varanasi. Second, City of Golden Temple. Many of you must have visited the Golden Temple also. Where it is? It is in Amritsar. So City of Golden Temple, that is Amritsar, and Amritsar is in Punjab. Third one is Garden City of India. Garden City of India, which city is known as Garden City of India? Bangalore. Okay, and this is there in Karnataka. Fourth one, Queen of Hill Stations. Queen of Hill Stations, that is Mussoorie. Here also you all must have visited this place. Okay, so City of Hill Stations, that is Mussoorie. Next one, fifth one is City of Pearls, that is Hyderabad. Sixth one, City of Nawabs. City of Nawabs, that is Lucknow. Seventh one, Paradise on Earth. Paradise, that means kind of heaven on earth. Which is that place? Kashmir. Okay, you all must have heard about Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, so there, it's there in our India map at the top. Okay, so that is Paradise on Earth. All the mountains and snow and all such kind of very heavenly atmosphere you will find in Kashmir. Eighth one is Pink City. I have given you the example just now in the beginning. So Pink City, tell me, Pink City is Jaipur, okay? You all must have visited Jaipur also, okay? So Jaipur is also known as Pink City. Why Jaipur is known as Pink City? Because Hawa Mahal is there and all the places which that is usually made with that red stone, okay? So that's why Jaipur is also known as Pink City. When you will visit the old Jaipur, na old areas of Jaipur, you will generally find these kind of buildings, this color of buildings, okay? Ninth one is City of Joy. City of Joy, that is Kolkata, okay? Now next we start with chapter 21, that is homophones. Now what do you understand by homophones? See, sometimes same spellings are there, but the meaning of those words are very different. Okay, let me give you one example. What do you understand by rose? What is a rose? Rose is a flower according to you. R-O-S-E, that is a flower according to you. But R-O-S-E is used in something else also. Okay, it is also a past tense of rise, R-I-S-E, rise, okay, like the sun rises, that is the wo wala rise, okay, and the past tense of rise is R-O-S-E, okay. So you can see same spellings are there, but the meanings are different, okay. So we are going to read about such words in this chapter. Homophones refer to words that sound the same but have different spellings and meanings, and sometimes the spellings are also same but the meanings are different. Given below are some sets of homophones. Circle the correct word describing the given picture. Now you can see this picture, okay? In this picture we are talking about the tail of a cow, okay? Now first one is T-A-I-L, tail, and second one is T-A-L-E. Now tell me, what is the difference between these two? Just guess, what is the difference between T-A-I-L and T-A-L-E? See, when we are talking about an animal, the tail of an animal, then we are going to use T-A-I-L, okay? And this T-A-L-E is fairy tale, okay? In this tale, like, it's a story. When we are talking about some story, you all must have heard about fairy tales. So that fairy tales, okay, that is this one tale, okay? Second one is sail, and again sail. Now what is the difference between S-A-I-L and S-A-L-E? Okay, S-A-I-L, okay, when we are talking about the boats, okay, ships. And second, S-A-L-E is sale, when we are selling something, or like you can see many of the time online sales are there, okay. So that sale, buying and selling, that sale is this, okay. Third one is, what is this? Kya hai ye? This is a sun. So S-U-N or S-O-N? S-U-N, you all must be knowing this, S-U-N is a sun. Now what does this sun means, S-O-N? This is your brother, okay? Like aapki mummy ka beta, this one is that sun, okay? S-O-N matlab beta. Next we move upon fourth one, R-E-I-G-N, rain, and second one is rail. You can see the picture. Here we are talking about this rain, R-A-I-N, Barish, and this means like a period of something, some king or kisi ka region, kisi ka empire, kisi particular king ka koi particular time period, okay? So this means that. Fifth one is, you can see now what it is, H-A-I-R or H-A-R-E? See, H-A-I-R you all must be knowing, that is your hair, okay? This hair, you comb your hair, okay? So H-A-I-R is your hair, and H-A-R-E is a animal, okay? This sixth one is plane or plain. You can see the picture, what we are talking about, P-L-A-N-E or P-L-A-I-N? Tell me, we are talking about P-L-A-N-E, aeroplane, okay? In aeroplane, in the last A-E-R-O-P-L-A-N-E we use, okay? So we are talking about plane, and this plane means very simple. Okay, seventh one is, you can see this rope. Okay, a knot is there. KNOT or NOT? NOT matlab nahi. Okay, so we are not talking about this knot, but we are talking about this knot, that is KNOT, that is to tie something, not tie a knot. Okay, so we are talking about this knot. Eighth one is, you can see, TOW or TOE? We are talking about TOE. Okay, and TOW means to tie something, that is the past tense of tie. Ninth one is eight or eight. You all must have learned the spellings of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are in this, we are talking about the spelling of eight, that is EIGHT, and this eight means to eat something, kuch khana. Okay, ATE, that is the past tense of eat. Okay, I ate my food. Okay, so this is the past tense of eat. Okay, now we are going to read about chapter 22. Now chapter 22 is 7 ancient wonders. Now what do you understand by ancient? That means something belonging to very distant past or maybe not, no longer in existence also. Okay, so we are going to read about such ancient wonders. So first one is statue of Zeus. Okay, so this, okay, let me read this also. The seven wonders of the ancient world were first designated by Antipater of Sidon, an ancient Greek poet. Now who is Antipater of Sidon? That is an ancient Greek poet. He was a Greek poet in the 2nd century BC. Identify each picture and write their names using the help box. Help box again you have been given at the down of this page. So first one is statue of Zeus. Statue of Zeus, that is in Olympic, Greece. Second one you can see, this is an ancient temple. Okay, and this temple is in Turkey. The name is Temple of Artemis. Okay, third one you can see this monument. This monument is in Egypt and it is Great Sphinx of Giza. What it is? Great Sphinx of Giza. Okay, fourth one you can see, Tomb of Mausolus. Where it is? It is again in Turkey. Okay, fifth one, Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Where it is? Hanging Gardens of Babylon, it is there in Iraq. Sixth one, Lighthouse of Alexandria. Lighthouse of Alexandria, where it is? It is there in Egypt. Okay, Great Sphinx of Giza was there in Egypt, and this Lighthouse of Alexandria is also there in Egypt. Seventh one, Colossus of Rhodes, that is in Greece. Okay, Colossus of Rhodes, that is in Greece. Please write down everything very carefully. Okay, write down all the spellings very carefully. So this is it all for today. Thank you.